While this month could potentially be offering some lucrative prospects for you, Cancer, overall the theme here is that you are really going to be reconsidering your finances, values, and maybe even the way that you derive your sense of security overall. There could also be a lot of focus on communication and your day-to-day routines, as well as some disruptions that could be resulting in delays or miscommunications. It never hurts to have a contingency plan, especially if you plan on traveling in the month of August. If you're excited for this month's reading, then definitely be sure to hit like, subscribe, and the bell notification so you can always stay up to date with what's in the cards for you. For those of you who are brand new to my channel, my name is Michael, and I utilize tarot and tropical astrology to intuit monthly forecasts for your zodiac sign. For those of you who are ready for a deep dive, you can find all of my links in the description box down below for personal readings and distance Reiki sessions, as well as all of my other social media accounts. As I'm shuffling the deck for you, Cancer, I do want to just give my disclaimer that these are general readings, meaning not all of the messages that come forward are going to be meant for you specifically. It is up to your own intuition and discernment to figure out what messages apply for you and what should be left behind for somebody else. If these messages just aren't resonating, nothing went wrong, this reading just isn't for you, you are welcome to check out the other videos, maybe for your moon or rising sign, for greater clarity, or for a message that might be more aligned for you this month. I do recommend checking out the rising sign, particularly for the astrology, but really pick the video that you feel most called to. And you may actually be getting messages that you are meant to share with other people as well. Some of these messages might be applying to people that you care about, and maybe you should share this video with them if you feel so called. What are the messages that we have for Cancer? And as I'm kind of shuffling here, I'm also thinking about the astrology. We do actually start off the month with a full moon in Aquarius. Interesting that we have the Three of Cups here on the table for you. This is showing up as past influence or early influence. I do feel like there is some sort of celebration at the beginning of this month, Cancer. You are celebrating something. You might be reconnecting with other people. It feels like you are gathered together in some way. I honestly wonder if there's even some sort of ritual or occult practice that you were doing at the start of this month. Maybe you're doing a full moon ritual with friends or with other people. Maybe you're doing a ritual by yourself. I only think of this because we do have the full moon in Aquarius, which represents your astrological eighth house of the occult, as well as sexuality and finances. Basically, anything that could be considered taboo. But it feels like you're connecting with other people. And that's why I'm wondering if there's some sort of rite or ritual that you are participating in at the beginning of this month. Overall, I would say that the beginning of August is a really good time to get things done, especially as we have more planets going retrograde. We have Mercury and Uranus going retrograde at the end of this month. We already have Venus retrograde. We actually have six retrograde planets, so that's six planets that appear to be moving backwards in the month of August. And so even though we're in Leo season and it's this exciting and dramatic time, it's also very introspective. It's very deep. It's very spiritual. It's a lot of reevaluation that's happening this month. And part of what's becoming clear for you, Cancer, is the Knight of Cups in reverse. Some of you have just felt disconnected from your heart or from your spirit. Maybe some of you have felt like creatively blocked, or that you're just emotionally blocked in some way. But it feels like there is support. You're getting a little help from your friends here with the Three of Cups. We do actually have the moon in reverse as well. And I find this very interesting because we do have Neptune that just went retrograde at the end of July. And Neptune going retrograde really does help clarify things. Neptune represents illusions. It represents fantasies. It's this sort of foggy energy. It's very intuitive, very dreamy, but it's not very clear most of the time. And when it goes retrograde, its energy kind of pulls back and it allows us to get a clearer perspective on things. And for you in particular, Cancer, this is in your ninth house of foreign travel, of education, of wisdom, anything that broadens your horizons. But I really do feel like there is this perspective shift that is happening for you this month, Cancer. There is this cloud that is lifting, and it's helping you see things clearly, but it's also making you recognize the ways that you might be burnt out that you didn't actually see before. And I do feel like you are replenishing yourself this month. So we do have the star here as well. I feel like there's a lot of healing that is happening. I'm actually specifically hearing something about energy healing. Some of you are doing Reiki or some sort of alternative or holistic healing practice or integrative healing practice. It feels like there is some sort of energy work that is being done on you or that you are doing on yourself that is helping you find alignment. For others of you, you are connecting with water or connecting with something that you love, and that is also being that's something that's nourishing you on a very deep level. It's very healing for you, very replenishing. And I think you're coming out of a very heavy and emotional time with the moon in reverse, and it's almost like this sigh of relief that I'm getting with the star. I do also see the King of Pentacles in your future, and this makes so much sense because there really is so much focus on your abundance this month, Cancer. We have the Sun and Venus coming together in your second house in Leo, which is bringing opportunities for you financially or giving you a lot of clarity for you financially. And this is actually a really great time to manifest as well. We actually have a new moon in Leo as well on the 17th. So really the middle of August feels like a good time to manifest or establish abundance. We do also have this new moon joining with Venus, but also interacting in kind of a harsh way with Uranus in Taurus. And this is kind of an interesting energy because Uranus is a bit of a wild card. And there could be this sort of volatile energy or this very sudden or unexpected beginning. But I don't want you to panic because it feels like there is something where you are getting greater abundance. It's like an unexpected source of abundance. Or that could be the silver lining in a situation. I really do wonder what's happening for you kind of in your social networks, because I feel like there's a lot of focus on connecting with other people with the Three of Cups. And we do have a lot of activation in Taurus this month as well. You know, Leo and Taurus are kind of interacting quite a bit. So what is happening for Cancer? Interesting. We have the Emperor in reverse. There is a structure that's being turned on its head. Interesting. I feel like you're cutting through someone's facade with the Queen of Swords and the Emperor in reverse. There is a truth that is coming out about someone, maybe someone who's acting narcissistically or selfishly. And it feels like other people are seeing this. And maybe there's something, Cancer, there's someone you have seen as problematic that other people haven't. And now, something that is shifting for you this month is that other people are recognizing the patterns that you were detecting or trying to inform other people about. Now they are seeing it for themselves. And I think that could be a source of healing. I feel like there are boundaries that are being drawn around someone, potentially an Aries, or again, just a very strong energy, kind of traditionally masculine, but this feels like a shadow masculine energy. So someone who is out of their power and is vying for power, as opposed to being in their own innate power. Someone who's trying to be controlling, someone who's trying to bring people down so they can feel better about themselves. I feel like with the Queen of Swords, you are drawing very clear boundaries with an individual or people who are behaving in this way. And you may even be cutting people out or blocking people. That could actually be something that's happening with Mercury going retrograde in Virgo at the end of this month, right as we begin Virgo season on the 23rd. there's a lot of you rethinking the ways that you communicate and the people that you communicate with more specifically. And there could be people that you are just deciding that you don't want to be in contact with any longer. And I'm specifically getting people who are either in your friendship circles or in your social circles, or people even following you online. Maybe you are blocking someone online. Those are all different ways that this energy could manifest. What else do we have for Cancer this month? So kind of just reviewing some things we were talking about. The middle of August is a really great time for manifestation. The beginning of August is a really good time to get things done. Where things get a little dicey is the end of August. Kind of looking at the 22nd, the last day of Leo season, we actually have a couple of things going on where it's almost like too much of a good thing with Venus and Jupiter forming a square with each other. For you in particular, Cancer, this is not a good time for you to spend money or to invest in things. Don't be making rash financial decisions. There's also Mars in Virgo opposing Neptune in Pisces on the same day. And again, Mars represents action and Neptune represents illusions and kind of these crazy heightened emotional states and sensitivities. And so the energy is just kind of volatile around that time. And it kind of feels like needing to be centered. And there could be other people. Wow. Yeah. Seven of Wands, needing to defend yourself from other people. It feels like other people are very volatile around this time, especially with the Magician in reverse and the Seven of Swords. Wow. I feel like someone is trying to pull a fast one, and there could be some sort of deception or some sort of ruse around this time, but I think you see through it. We do have the Magician in reverse. Sometimes the Magician represents someone who has something up his sleeve. Seven of Swords is definitely a very sneaky energy, and it feels like, I don't know, there's just people who are giving you bad vibes, and I feel like you are needing to have boundaries or feeling like you're defending your energy or defending yourself in some way. Interesting. I'm actually hearing specifically there's someone who might seem like a soulmate or a twin flame or just some sort of special relationship, but this is actually someone that you need to steer clear of. This is a karmic relationship or a relationship that offers a lot of learning. And I mean, honestly, I don't really talk about twin flame relationships. I don't really do that on this channel so much. Not because I don't believe that this isn't, that it's not at all a real thing, but I think it's mostly just toxic relationships that are labeled as twin flames. I think twin flame relationships are very, very different. And I feel like some of you with the Magician in reverse, there's someone who seems very impressive and very spiritual, and the connection seems really powerful, and it's like you almost feel like you're fending them off, but they actually don't have the best intentions, or they're just very out of alignment with themselves. So again, boundaries are really, really important this month, Cancer. I know what this is. Okay. It just kind of clicked. There is someone from your past who is trying to communicate with you, and this makes perfect sense with Mercury going retrograde in your third house of communication. This feels like a person who once might have felt like a soulmate or you believed was a twin flame or this really significant relationship. I feel like they've already done you dirty. The damage has been done here, and it's like they're kind of trying to come back into your life. But honestly, Cancer, I just see you like the Seven of Wands. You're like, nah, fending this person off. You're like, I don't want anything to do with this energy. If this isn't a soulmate, this could just be another sneaky figure from the past. But I do feel like it's just really important to be mindful of different people coming back or different people messaging you or even people that you are thinking about right now. This is a time of review. It's not necessarily about reconciling a relationship or anything like that. It's almost like a test. And I think you know that, Cancer. I think you know whose energy is not actually appropriate for you, especially if you're dealing with an Aries, also a Virgo or Gemini. So very interesting story there. You're going to have to let me know in the comments down below if you do get anyone reaching out to you or sliding into your DMs or even just asking your friends about you. That's actually something I could really see as well. I feel like there's someone who's trying to kind of crawl their way back into your life, and they might be trying to get to your friends or, you know, get in through your life in some sort of alleyway. But again, I'm really not that concerned about it. I think you already are well aware of this person if there is someone coming back. Are there any other messages for Cancer? Any other messages for Cancer? We have the Three of Pentacles actually coming up in the reverse. So again, there could be some breakdown with you and coworkers or on some sort of project or some sort of community endeavor. And again, I think Four of Swords, letting things rest, taking some time to recharge. Don't do the work for a group of people if no one else is doing the work. You know, I kind of think of like those group projects that we get in school that really ends up being one person doing all the work. I kind of feel like that could be a situation some of you might find yourself in. And so have your boundaries there as well. And it's really like, don't try to force things to happen right now, Cancer. There's a lot of really confusing energy at the end of the month. Things really slow down. With Mercury retrograde, we have 6 retrograde planets. So again, very introspective energy. We do have Uranus going retrograde in Taurus on the 28th. This could be signifying some sort of sudden change in your social groups or your friendship circles or even in your social media. And it kind of does feel like there might be some sort of breakdown around this time, if I'm being honest. We do also have a full moon at the end of this month. That's right, we have 2 full moons in August, and this is a full moon in Pisces on the 30th. And this full moon is actually interesting because it's also connected to Saturn in Pisces. And so this could end some sort of karmic period. This could represent the ending of a challenging cycle or a loosening of a challenging cycle, especially relative to your education or travel or anything that is about kind of the world at large, broadening your horizons in some way. There could be the end of some sort of trip or journey or degree for you, or some sort of commitment around these things that is happening at the end of this month. But yeah, I feel like there's just this kind of breakdown in communication. There are people who you need to be discerning with, especially people who are wanting to work with you on something, Cancer. Because I feel like you have a lot of abundance. You actually have a lot of really good things going for you. And honestly, it's kind of like, I talk about this a lot on my channel, where it's like, when you get into a period where you're just about to turn a corner and things are about to improve, there are people who just smell this. They just know. And you'll start to hear from all of these people from the past, because on some level they sense that something is about to shift and they want a piece of that too. And it's almost a little parasitic. And that's kind of how I wanted to talk about the magician in the past. Like, it feels like there is an energy vampire around you, Cancer. So it is important that you are kind of mindful of that. But overall, I see a lot of healing for you. I see a lot of abundance. I see a lot of stability. And I think it's just important to focus on yourself, honestly, at least for the month of August. Are there any other messages? Anything else for Cancer? Interesting. We have the Eight of Wands, so some exciting news coming in. Also, the King of Swords. A lot of clarity, a lot of messages. I feel like the one thing that's going to come about from someone reaching out from the past is that you're going to get answers about things. Maybe someone was unfaithful with the Ace of Wands in reverse. Maybe there was just some sort of conflict. But looking at this Eight of Wands and King of Swords, I feel like there are downloads that are happening for you at the end of this month. You're just understanding things. You're getting clarity. You're getting answers. And you're being very logical about things. You know, it's really interesting because we first started off this reading with a lot of water. We had the Three of Cups, the Knight of Cups, the Moon, and even the Star. All of these cards have very watery themes to them. And then it kind of shifted to Pentacles and Wands and Swords. But there's definitely a lot of swords. There's definitely a lot of stuff with the mind, logic, being analytical, being discerning, and also being very practical with the abundance of pentacles here. I feel like you're just becoming a lot more stable and you're done with certain patterns, you're done with certain cycles, and I think that's something that's going to be very clear to you by the end of August. And honestly, I think you're going to be very proud of yourself. You're going to see how far you've come, Cancer. And there's just a lot of beautiful growth in pretty much every sense of the word for you this month. And that is where I will leave off today's reading. I do hope that this was helpful. Be sure to hit like and subscribe, comment and share this video. All of the engagement does help this channel grow and helps me continue putting out these messages for all of you. You can also find links in the description of this video for personal readings and distance Reiki sessions. And you're also welcome to check out the other videos, maybe for your moon or rising sign. There could be messages there for you as well. And I will see you all next time. I'm wishing you a very happy and blessed August. Take care, Cancer.